Hi everyone, and welcome back to Curious by Nature. My name is Airen, and today we're inspecting a seriously special animal, the snake. There are thousands of different types of snakes in the world. Some are as thin as a piece of spaghetti, and some are almost as long as a school bus. They can be all sorts of different colors and found in lots of different habitats. Snakes are a unique shape in the animal world, and there's so much to learn about them. Today, we're going to take a look at something beneath their skin that all snakes have in common, their skeleton. Before we get started, if you love nature and science videos like this one, be sure to join our community. Give this video a like and subscribe to our channel so you never miss an episode. Ready? Let's take a closer look at some snake skeletons. Here with me is Cornelius, one of our resident corn snakes. Although snakes don't have arms or legs, there are three parts of their skeleton that they have in common with us. Let's take a closer look at three different features all snakes have: their spine and vertebrae, ribs, and skull. Let's start with their vertebrae. All snakes are vertebrates, which means they have a backbone. Humans are vertebrates too. We have a backbone, and our spinal column starts at the base of our skull and runs down our back. Cornelius's starts just behind his skull and goes to the very tip of his tail, almost the whole length of his body. Cornelius's long backbone and vertebrae give him a lot of flexibility, allowing him to wrap his body around prey or quickly slither away from a predator, like hawks or coyotes. Humans and snakes both have ribs to protect their inner organs, but snakes actually have way more ribs than us. Along those vertebrae, Cornelius has ribs that start a little behind his head and end a little bit before his tail. Like us, snakes have lungs, a heart, and a stomach, and they're all protected by this very long line of ribs. Here at the Nature Museum, our scientists play an active role in the conservation and stewardship of local wildlife species, including butterflies, Blanding's turtles, and snakes. A whole team across Illinois that includes the Nature Museum is working to conserve the smooth green snake population by monitoring existing populations, surveying the areas that could support a population, and head-starting young snakes from eggs of wild adults and supplementing them back to their parents' site in the wild. By incubating and hatching eggs, this program is able to overcome the most vulnerable time in a snake's life cycle. To find out more about smooth green snakes, visit our website. Want to learn more about how you can help care for some of the Nature Museum's animals, including our endangered and threatened species? Check out our volunteer opportunities at naturemuseum.org/volunteer. That's our episode for today. Now that we've had a chance to take a closer look at snake anatomy, let's make a snake of our own. Check out our description for a guide to making your own origami snake. Or if you're ready to learn more about super snakes, we've picked out these episodes for you. If you have any questions about snakes, be sure to drop them in the comments below. We hope you enjoyed getting up close with these super special snakes, and we'll see you back here next time on Curious by Nature.